Now about the Holloman.
Oh God.
To round out the ensemble, we got Greg Grunberg, aka Fat Keanu Reeves.
Sure, Joey Slotnick.
Okay, Joey Slotnick.
Now this is where my thing comes in.
Yes. Oh, here we go.
Yes.
I need help with this.
Okay,
because this is important to me, and this is a big part of why I was thinking about this movie a lot when it came out. Do you remember? And if not, someone in your fandom, a blankie, has to provide this. Do you remember how much Craig Kilborn made Joey Slotnick a running gag?
No.
Forever.
Slotnick was like his Abe Vigoda?
Yes.
Why?
100%. I don't know.
Was Slotnick a part of the gag? Like,
no.
Would he show up?
He was always there.
Oh, okay.
Joey Slotnick was always on Craig Kilborn.
As himself.
Because Craig Kilborn seemed to have some relationship with Jonathan Silverman.
Okay.
They seemed to be friends.
Okay.
So he was in the single guy orbit.
Yep. Sure.
Yep. And therefore he was always...
we're just staying right in 1995. Yeah. We're just never leaving.
Yes, that's right.
So he was part of the SGU.
He was all... Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you got Ming-Na. You got Ernest Borgnine.
See, they weren't made fun of by Slotnick. Kilborn.
Yeah,
but
he
was deep into the single guy somehow.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And Slotnick was always the butt of some running joke on Kilborn that I can neither remember nor find
amazing.
Online. I cannot remember it nor find it.
Oh, I see. So you remember this happening,
so
but
for
you
the
don't have evidence
month
of it.
Leading up to the release of Hollow Man, Kilborn was always talking about Slotnick, and Slotnick must have been on 5 or 6 times. He would pop into the beginning. He would be a cutaway.
So you were watching Kilborn every night.
Every night. Which is another reason I knew this movie came out in the summer.
Yeah. Because
I was watching Kilborn every night.
So this is Kilborn.
This is incredible.
Post Daily Show? Or is this?
This is late night after Letterman.
This is when he's late night.
I could watch Letterman, then watch Kilborn.
He gets late night 99,
right.
I think. So this is early Kilborn late
night.
And
the way he wants to make his mark on late night is by having some running gag with Slotnick that I barely remember, but remember so vividly as happening. So when I had the opportunity to... Because I was not invited to be here. I asked to be here.
Yeah.
It was because I need to just see if anyone else remembers how or why.
Joey Slotnick.
Kilborn was always talking about Joey Slotnick to the extent that when I saw this movie with my friends.
Right.
And when he came on, I said, there's Joey Slotnick. Thinking that this would be funny.
Yeah.
I thought everyone knew that
they were in on the joke.
The words Joey Slotnick could get a laugh.
He was like snakes on a plane.
Yes. Truly. And I can't remember what this was or why, but someone else has to be able to. There's no proof. I Googled it for a little bit.
Yeah, you like tried
Couldn't
to.
Find anything. There's no clips of like, 10-minute compilation of Kilborn Slotnick.
You know, one problem I think that you have is that I think CBS has just erased Craig Kilborn from the internet.
Yes.
Like, they just don't want to acknowledge that ever happened.
Yeah.
Well, the other thing that I know connects this is that I believe also summer 2000, maybe 2001, when Jon Favreau's Maid came out.
Uh-huh. Sure. His directorial debut.
Jonathan Silverman is in that movie very briefly.
Okay.
And that was also a big running Kilborn thing. He kept every time Favreau or Vince Vaughn would be on the show, he'd be like, most important question, why is Jonathan Silverman only in one scene of the movie?
Oh my God.
So this is my real reason for being here today. It's not that Paul Verhoeven's one of my favorite filmmakers.
Yeah.
And I wanted to re-examine his most unheralded film.
You've been waiting. You've had like an alert for when we're going to cover a Slotnick.
Yeah. And I just, there's something about this that I can't remember. Because then he's just like science dork number 3.
Yeah.
Like, he's just the nerd who wears sweater vests with a tie.
Do you think...
Yeah, he has no role in this movie. It's almost insulting.
It's unbelievable how many...
Movie.
The whole... Before I remembered
like,
that this movie
he
becomes...
Die?
He just gets killed like everyone else.
He just gets stabbed with a crowbar.
Through the chest.
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
Before I remembered that this movie just becomes like a slasher, I was like, why are there so many people in this movie?
There's a lot of people in it.
Like, what is there? Because there's him. So now, okay, so my Slotnick thing is planted. I've let that out there.
Right. So anyone who wants to get at Alex Ross Perry about Joey Slotnick and Craig Kilborn's relationship.
Just somewhere I'll look at your Reddit and I'll try to figure out if anyone else is like, I watched Kilborn and I actually remember what you're
talking
about.
What's your home mailing address? Can I send you a letter?
Yeah. And what's your annual salary?
Do you want my theory? I got a theory, and I don't remember this bit, right? I was not a
Kilborn.
You were
too young for, right? Yeah. Oh, yeah, you weren't a Kilborn.
Although
you're not Kilborn again?
No, I would sneak, like, stay awake and watch Conan on my little, like, rabbit ear TV. I never dipped in the Kilborn. But my bet is that those were, like, his drinking buddies. That his, like, pussy posse, if I may, at the time, was, like, Silverman, Slotnick, like some weird group of like NBC, like primetime, like
God.
Hammocked in between
what
friends
depressing. Yeah.
And Mad About You sitcom guys.
When they would like try and launch like Union Square out of Friends, right? Like that run of failed sitcoms.
Right. And it was like an inside
Veronica's
joke
Closet
that he tried to make happen with the American public about him.
Worked for me.
Yeah. Yeah. Look, and
made me super aware of Hollow Man. and made me, you know, 17 yeah. years later, be like, there was something about Slotnick.
It's
and,
like a splinter yeah. in your mind. You can't, like,
and I looked him up. If it works for even one person, then it was worth
man,
it.
Man, Slotnick's Wikipedia page is really depressing.
Is it? Oh,
I mean,
God.
Not that there's any, it just looks
oh,
like,
no.
it just has very little effort put
His
into it.
His profile picture is him shaking hands with Steve Wozniak, who he looks nothing like,
and
yet played
in
Pirates of Silicon Valley.
Just, like, I feel like his page, like, it doesn't
look
have,
at this, like, sort of bizarre tableau.
It doesn't have, like, links to the movies. It's just a list of movies.
Yeah. Well, then it becomes just, like, because it's some movies, like Twister, Pirates of Silicon, right? And then it's just TV shows. Mm-hmm. It's like Alias, CSI, Boston Legal, you know, like,
Twister,
just,
by the way, is another cool scientist movie.
That's true. That's true. Yeah, yeah, yeah. These scientists, they drive cars and
they're
stuff,
like, kind of fun, normal, down-to-earth mm-hmm. people. Another Apollo 13 turned lead in a cool scientist movie.
Very
cast
true.
Member.
That's, yeah, that's right. Every Apollo, because Gary Sinise got something, too, out of this, right? Like, he had to have something. Come on, help me out here.
Well, he was in Reindeer Games. He's not a cool scientist. But.
No, he's not. Maybe, yeah.
Whatchamacallit? Snake Eyes?
He doesn't really scream scientist. He screams more, you know, authority figure.
Yeah, he's your Fed. Yeah, I mean, well, Snake Eyes, he's the villain. Spoiler.
So
yeah.
Did the cool hacker replace the cool scientists, right?
I guess
that,
so.
I feel like that becomes the next
the
trope
cool
where he's
tech.
Like, I'm a cool tech guy. Right. It's like yeah. the Blade guy.
Because
you know?
Then it becomes your scientists are the nerds again. And mm-hmm. then there's this guy who's got kind of like frosted tips or something. And he's got like a, you know, a mug full of pistachio nuts
well,
or something.
Wait,
yeah.
is it Greg Grunberg who's always drinking a big gulp in this movie?
Yes, yes, yes.
So that's like his kind of, and he always has headphones around
yeah.
his head. And he's looking at porn. He's looking at Perfect
looking
10
at
magazine.
Porn and like has like a whole monologue.
He's sitting there
like,
muttering,
oh, I'd suck the nipples off those
that's
tits
what he says.
Or something. And you're like, who's, no one's ever said that.
That feels like someone being like, Verhoeven movies are gross and lurid and people talk about sex.
Well,
so we're going to have this character talk about nipples while he's looking at this Perfect 10 at his job in a bunker where there's only like six people who have the access. Code.
Right. Andrew W. Marlowe is the writer of this movie.
I'm sorry. I found confirmation on something I need to share. Joey Slotnick in 2009
yeah.
did a stage production.
Oh, no. This is already bad.
I don't like this.
At the Williamstown Theater Festival.
Oh, that's, okay. that's nice. That's fun.
Okay. Yeah, that's
okay.
cool. Yeah.
Or no, I'm sorry. That was several years into making this happen. It started at Chicago.
Okay.
Of Animal Crackers. The Marx
okay.
Brothers
okay.
movie, which they tried to turn into a musical, I think in the hopes of going to Broadway, and Joey Slotnick played Groucho Marx.
Mm.
He spent most of the last like 7 years
trying
touring
to
around
happen.
Trying to become the stage version of Groucho
That's his,
Marx.
Like his Kilmer Twain? Oh, yeah. Look
well,
at
here,
that.
No, flip your phone back around.
Interesting. Oh, yeah, okay. there he is. There yeah. he is with the glasses and the mustache.
Yeah, he's trying to make Groucho happen.
Well, there's something about Slotnick.
There's definitely something about
Slotnick.